Melanie Couper was a solo mother selling insurance when she found her passion for property. She made her first purchase in 1989 of an investment property in Adelaide, and she has bought over 60 homes since. She's written a book about it. It is called Real Estate Adventures, How I Had Fun While Making Millions in Property, and she joins me now. Thank you so much for coming on. Good morning, Sally.
Good morning, Sarah.
So why write the book?
I love helping people. It was originally going to be called If I Can Do It, Anyone Can.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not hard. A huge percentage of millionaires made their money in property. And people started asking me, you know, how do you do it? What do you do? How do I get started? So somebody said to me, you should write a book.
So how do you get started? This was 1989. I mean, it was a different market than it is now, and this was in Adelaide. What sort of prompted you, your own personal story?
Well, my first investment property was bought nearly 10 years ago, which was 1999. And I was just turning 50. I had four children, and I'd bought them up and paid for them to go to school and all that sort of thing. And I really had nothing myself. And I thought, well, you know, I really want to be able to have a nice time in my life and have some fun and travel. And so to do that, you need money.
That is so true.
And I read Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki.
Who we just had on the show a couple of weeks ago.
Yes, that book has changed thousands, probably millions of lives all over the world. It's a simple, fantastic book. I read it.
And what was it in that book that made you think, I'm going to go and buy an investment property?
Ah, well, I discovered that you could do a thing called positive gearing. Now, that meant you could buy a house and the rent would pay the mortgage payments. And I went and had a look at several in the northern suburb of Adelaide for about $30,000.
You couldn't get that now, though.
No, but guess what it's worth now?
A lot more.
Close to 200.
That's incredible. And I suppose that is my big question. It's almost like, is it too late for people to get started? And that's, you know, like, even though we weren't making the same money we were making 10 years ago, you know, now it's worked, you know, it's, you know, God knows how many times that is, like 20 times what you paid for it or 5 times what you paid for it. Our purchasing power is so much less now because houses are so much more expensive.
Well, that is true. However, if you look at history, which does repeat itself, for the last 2,000 years of recorded real estate transactions, real estate has doubled on average every 10 years. And that means that it goes up by about 7 to 10% a year on average. Now, at the moment, we're in a bit of a down. And some years, it goes down. Some years it stays level, and some years it goes up. But that's the average.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I started close to 10 years ago in a similar time in the cycle to now. We're at the bottom of the cycle, and then it goes up, and you have a boom, and everybody's buying and jumps on the bandwagon, and then it levels off and goes down, and then there's another recession like there is now. So I would say that now is the best time to buy for the next 10 years.
But house prices in New Zealand have not actually come down that much. And we still have relatively high interest rates compared to the rest of the world. And banks are being really tough on loaning money at the moment. You can't just go and get 100% mortgage like you could. So
I know.
What's your advice to people who say, well, I'd love to buy an investment property, but I just don't have the deposit? And there's no such thing as positive gearing at the moment either, because rents are not covering the mortgage, I would imagine.
Well, actually, there's been quite a change. It was very, very hard to do positive gearing for some years. But now, I mean, I'm working in Christchurch, and my son's actually building us a new rental house in Belfast there, and I've done the figures, and that is going to be neutral to positive with the current interest rates. They are about, like, we were paying 9 or 10% a year ago, and now they're about 5, 5.5. So in effect, your payments have just about halved. And the rents are very strong. So it is a good time to start. Now, you were saying, how can somebody start?
Yes.
There's a common misconception that it takes money to make money. And Robert Kiyosaki would be the first one to agree with me that, in fact, it doesn't. What it does take is some knowledge, some education. You can get joint venture partners. We're doing a joint venture at the moment in Adelaide where we have no money in, and we're going to make about $75,000 when it's sold. Somebody else is getting the mortgage who's got, you know, no mortgageability problems whatever.
So why would they want to go in with you?
Because we are going to actually find the property, which we've done, manage the renovation, do the subdivision, do all the work, because we have experience.
And I think that's something we have to talk about. So what you're talking about is buying a property or building a property and then flicking it and making a profit.
Yes.
How do you get knowledgeable enough to do that? And I know we've got a list here, which we'll bring up and we'll talk about, because you've got sort of a list of things that you should do, and I think, and then you talk about education. First of all, look in the newspapers.
Yes. I would also be reading books, especially mine.
Yes, of course.
And Robert Kiyosaki's and Dolph DeRusse's. I'd be getting CD packets about real estate. Dolph DeRusse has got a wonderful one called Wealth Magnet. Mm-hmm. I'd be watching DVDs. I'd be going to every seminar I could lay my hands on. I'd be mixing with people who are already in property investors, who are doing it successfully, and hanging around them and learning what they do.
What would you be looking for in the newspapers? Are you just talking about the houses for sale?
Yes, I'd look in the real estate section. And I'd read what they're saying, because there's always some articles there which are very informative. And I'd find out, like, what areas are likely to go up more than other areas. Mm. I mean, sometimes in Australia there's a lot of mining going on at the moment, and if you can buy near a mining town or in a mining town, then your property values are likely to go up much faster than if you just bought somewhere that hasn't got anything major going on for it. So do some research on what's happening, new factories, new freezing works, new mines, that sort of thing, where the values are going to go up faster than the average.
Go to many open house or open home inspections.
Yes, that's a good idea, because you start to get the feel of what's available, how much it is. You look at what's wrong with the house or where it is. I mean, I buy houses that some people would say, oh, why did you buy that?
Yes.
Like, it might have a really overgrown lawn and need a coat of paint. Those are so easy to fix, but they can add $20,000 to the value. Easy.
Talk to agents, and this is a big, you know, question, because a lot of people have this image that you can't trust a real estate agent, which is ridiculous, of course, but there is, you know, they do get quite a bad rap.
Yeah, a bit like insurance salespeople, and I used to be one of those. and car salesmen.
How do you know you've got a good agent?
Well, it comes down a little bit to intuition and dealing with them. You need to create a relationship, ask them lots of questions, get them to show you different houses. What you want is an agent that's in there not just to make your commission, but's in there for a long-term relationship. If they know you're going to be an investor, then they'll be, you know, they have a vested interest in really looking after you. But you might need to interview a lot.
That's right. And, of course, they will end up calling you when they have good deals. And we won't talk about it. I just want to mention also talk to people who are investors already, which is a great idea.
Oh, absolutely.
Look, congratulations on the book, Sally. It's great. And I know it's a self-published book, so it's wonderful that you've got that out there and you're helping other people. Really good, easy read and with some great advice in there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And for more information on Sally's book, Real Estate Adventures, you can see our website. And we have 3 copies of the book to give away. And the question you have to answer is, where did Sally buy her first investment property? You can either enter online or send your answer to Good Morning, Sally Couper Giveaway, PO Box 31643, Lower Hutt 5040.